Chronic high blood sugar doesn't just affect your internal organs. It can lead to a wide range of issues on your skin, especially on your face. Appearance aside, are these conditions dangerous? Do they point to deeper, more serious medical issues? And is there anything you can do to reduce your risk of developing or shrink the size of these worrisome warning signs? If you are experiencing problematic skin and face issues, possibly due to diabetes, then you won't want to miss this vid. Stick around to the end of this video to learn about other rare but extremely serious warning signs of high blood sugar you may find on the outermost parts of your body. Now, lean in, because we're about to take a close look at 10 warning signs of diabetes on your face and skin, and what to do about it. Number 10. Skin tags. These small, soft growths, which look like deflated balloons attached to a stalk, are actually fairly common among a wide range of people. Also called acrocordons, skin tags usually form in areas where the skin folds, like the neck, armpits, and groin. Typically, they are harmless, but they could be a warning sign of diabetes. As insulin is a growth-stimulating hormone, research suggests that having high levels of insulin in the bloodstream due to chronic high blood sugar may lead to the formation of skin tags. In fact, a recent study found that participants with multiple skin tags had higher A1C levels than participants without skin tags. Other studies suggest that the presence of skin tags on the skin of diabetics may be an indicator of high cholesterol levels. And in general, it's been reported that skin tags are common in nearly 95% of the diabetic population. Number 9. Xanthelasma. These soft, yellow, bumpy patches of skin, typically found on or around eyelids, are simply deposits of cholesterol, but they can be an indicator of chronic high blood sugar and cardiovascular issues. There are multiple diabetes-related risk factors for this condition, including high blood pressure and high lipid levels. So, naturally, actively working to lower your cholesterol and glucose levels can work to reduce the formation of xanthelasma. In fact, certain statin medications prescribed to treat high cholesterol have also been found to treat this condition. There are also cosmetic procedures which can remove these yellow patches, such as chemical peels and laser surgery. But as always, doctors recommend fighting this and other skin issues by adjusting your diet. Decrease your consumption of high-fat, high-carb foods to lower your risk for xanthelasma. Number 8. Diabetic blisters. Blisters aren't just for musicians or athletes. They can also be a symptom of chronic high blood sugar. Diabetic blisters, or bullosis diabetic coram, can quickly appear on legs, feet, arms, and hands, and they may come in the form of a large single blister, or groups of smaller blisters. These sores resemble burn blisters, but are usually painless. Often found on hands, feet, legs, or forearms, diabetic blisters typically occur on those who are experiencing diabetic neuropathy. That means finding a blister of this type may be a warning sign that you are suffering from diabetes-related nerve damage. Therefore, if you believe that you may have a diabetic blister, it's best to speak with your doctor to check if you are also suffering the effects of diabetic neuropathy. Usually, these blisters will heal on their own after a few weeks, and for now, the only proven treatment for reducing the size and occurrence of diabetic blisters is to simply work to reduce your fasting blood sugar. Number 7. Velvet skin and darkened skin patches, aka acanthosis nigricans. Dark patches and dry, leathery, velvety-feeling skin may point to the diabetes-related skin condition known as acanthosis nigricans. Tan to brown-colored, raised areas can appear in those foldable regions of the skin, including the armpits, the neck, the groin, and even on elbows. This condition arises when epidermal skin cells atypically reproduce too rapidly. As we've mentioned, since insulin acts as a growth hormone, These dark patches are often triggered by high levels of free-floating insulin in the bloodstream. Acanthosis nigricans typically occurs on the skin of overweight individuals, but it may also be due to reactions of certain medications, stomach cancer, or a genetic predisposition. That's why it's important to speak with your doctor if you believe you are experiencing acanthosis nigricans, as it can be an indicator of prediabetes, type 2 diabetes, or other serious medical issues. Number 6. Thickened skin, dry skin, or scaly skin patches. Simply having diabetes raises the risk of having dry skin. That's because chronic high blood sugar can cause the body to lose fluids, which can take moisture away from the skin. This lack of moisture can cause skin, especially on arms and hands, to dry out, becoming scaly or patchy, thicken, and crack. Plus, as high glucose levels can cause the body to lose water through urine, diabetics are at an increased risk of dehydration, and being dehydrated can cause patches of scaly, rough, and itchy skin. In some cases, extremely dry skin can result in the condition keratosis pilaris, which is a buildup of dead skin cells and keratin. This blocks hair follicles and may lead to the formation of rough, bumpy spots. Though generally painless and harmless, these dry skin issues could be yet another sign of diabetes. Number 5. Bloodshot eyes. If you suffer from skyrocketing glucose levels plus high blood pressure, blood vessels within the eyes may become damaged. This can lead to small quantities of blood to leak into your vitreous, the fluid within your eye. Of course, this will create the appearance of a bloodshot eye. But this issue is more than just skin or eye deep. It could create scar tissue within the eye, which may lead to vision issues and even possibly retinal detachment. While eye drops can bring moisture back to red, bloodshot eyes, as usual, the best remedy is the natural method. Remove simple sugar snacks and starchy, low-fiber foods from your diet as much as possible. Number 4. Diabetic dermopathy. This skin condition presents as light brown, scaly, or hard, firm patches of skin on the legs, feet, the thighs, torso, and arms. Most often, diabetic dermopathy can be found on the lower legs, usually on or near the shins. Research suggests that this condition is a symptom of diabetic neuropathy, where nerve and blood vessels become damaged, especially in the legs. While diabetic dermopathy will not typically cause any discomfort, it's still important to watch for, as it can be yet another sign of poorly controlled blood sugar. Treatments include regular application of a moisturizing cream, or even injections of corticosteroids, which can work to reduce the inflammation associated with this condition. But as usual, we recommend going the natural route by eating foods which can help you decrease your risk of diabetic neuropathy. Check out the top 5 foods for fighting diabetic nerve pain by clicking the link above. Number 3. Face and eye puffiness. For some diabetics, chronic high blood sugar can lead to the body retaining water. This may then cause swelling in various areas of the skin, including in the face and under the eyes. Elevated levels of both glucose and insulin cause the kidneys to hold on to water and salt. But the body's way of telling you this is happening is by tissues around the eyes becoming puffy. And when glucose levels remain high, it can damage the blood vessels which carry oxygen and other nutrients to the face. This too can lead to puffy eyes, dark circles under the eyes, and sagging skin in and around the face. Puffiness around the eyes due to diabetes is not just an issue for your appearance. It may also lead to blurred vision and other complications with your eyesight. So, if you want to take the puffiness away from your face, a great place to start is by following the traditional steps for lower blood sugar, meaning adjust your diet accordingly and attempt regular physical activity, especially after you eat. Number 2. Diabetic ulcers, or wounds that won't quickly heal. Diabetic ulcers are common among diabetics. these sores and open wounds tend to heal slowly. Diabetic ulcers can be found most anywhere on the body, though they often develop on the feet and lower legs. As is the case with other diabetes-related skin issues, diabetic ulcers are typically caused by damage to blood vessels, which leads to poor circulation and can lengthen healing times. Diabetic ulcers can also be a symptom of diabetic neuropathy, where nerves become damaged by high levels of sugar in the bloodstream. But while other skin issues, on their own, are not incredibly serious, ulcers and slow-healing wounds should be addressed in a quick fashion. Ulcers that do not quickly heal are more prone to infection. So if you think you have an ulcer or slow-healing wound on your skin, it's best to have your doctor take a look. So, what is perhaps the most common and most worrisome diabetes-related skin condition? That's just ahead. But real quick, let's get you those three free gifts. Click the link in the description below and you'll get Superfoods for Diabetics, Episode 1 of that diabetes documentary, and the incredible cookbook, Snacks, Meals, and Desserts that Lower Blood Sugar. Grabbed these three knowledge-packed guides? Great! Now let's get a good look at perhaps the most significant sign of diabetes on your skin. Number 1. Skin tingling and numbness. Due to prolonged diabetic neuropathy, you may find that your skin, especially on hands and feet, is numb or feeling like pins and needles. Were you aware that upwards of 70% of diabetics experience some form of neuropathy? That's why the sensation of tingling or numb skin comes in at number 1 on this list, because this is the most obvious symptom of diabetic neuropathy. Poorly controlled blood sugar can lead to heightened levels of diabetic neuropathy, and increased numbness in the extremities, especially in the feet, can be especially dangerous for diabetics. That's because numbness in the legs and feet increases the risk of injuries, abnormal walking, slow healing sores, or wounds which can go unnoticed, and that may lead to a serious infection. So, if you currently suffer from diabetes, it's very important to check your feet daily. And if you feel that your feet are numb or tingling, you should speak with your doctor about the possibility that you are experiencing diabetic neuropathy. Unfortunately, diabetic neuropathy cannot be fully reversed, as damaged nerves will never completely heal. However, this condition, like other diabetes-related skin and nerve conditions, can be better managed through proper diet and other environmental factors, like regular physical activity and practicing good sleep habits. So now you know to keep an eye on your skin and face, to watch for these 10 warning signs of diabetes. There are still other, more rare skin conditions also related to diabetes, including digital sclerosis, which is thick, swelling on hands and feet. It can cause joints to become stiff, and it may lead to the spread of thicker, cracked skin up the legs, arms, and back. Though rare, it typically occurs in type 1 diabetics, and scientists believe it is caused by elevated glucose levels. Plus, watch out for eruptive xanthomatosis, which is the occurrence of red bumps with a yellow center around elbows, knees, and upper thighs. This condition is also generally rare and is caused by high cholesterol and triglycerides. So, if you find yourself experiencing any of these issues on your skin and face, your body is trying to tell you something. You may be suffering from heart disease or diabetes. But what can you and should you do about it? Naturally, the first line of defense is to take a close look at your diet. Attempt to cut back on simple sugar, carb-heavy, processed foods. Instead, go for a whole foods approach with quality complex carbohydrate, high-fiber foods like fruits, vegetables, and 100% whole grains. And don't forget about glucose-lowering protein with lean meats like chicken and turkey, or plant-based sources like beans, nuts, and seeds. If you want to improve your appearance and lessen these symptoms on your skin, you can also attempt shorter, cooler showers, as hot water may strip natural oils from your skin, which can lead to dryness. Use a moisturizer after shower to retain skin moisture and prevent dryness or cracking. And drink water throughout the day to replenish fluids typically lost through urine due to diabetes. If you are worried about diabetes and skin issues, be sure to keep an eye on your appearance and the skin all over your body, especially on your legs and feet. Not for vanity, but to check for the blisters, ulcers, infections, and other warning signs of chronic high blood sugar. And as always, it's extremely important to contact your doctor if you notice any of these signs of diabetes on your face or other areas of your skin. That about wraps up this topic. But what did you think? Are there any other diabetes-related skin issues you manage? Let us and our community know by commenting below. Don't forget to grab your 3 free gifts with the link below. And please like, subscribe, and feel free to show your appreciation for our content by clicking the thanks button. Thank you for watching. Please have yourself a happy, healthy, diabetes-fighting day.